On the commemoration of Marawi City's liberation from the Maute terrorist group, Colonel Jose Luntok looked back on the siege that shook the country and forever changed his life as a soldier. Colonel Luntok served as commanding officer of the 4th Scout Ranger Battalion during the siege that lasted for 5 long months. Because of his bravery and heroism, he was conferred with a Distinguished Conduct Star by the Armed Forces of the Philippines. Top officials of the AFP, led by its Chief of Staff General Gilbert Gapay, also offered flowers at the Heroes Memorial inside Camp Aguinaldo. According to the military, they will not let another Marawi siege to happen again. They are looking on the core of the problem, which according to them is the radicalization of the youth in Mindanao.
We're looking now, coordinating with DepEd, looking into different schools, particularly in Sulu and other parts of Mindanao, because it is in this, it is one of the institutions or areas where recruitment is occurring.
Sulu Governor Abdo Sakurtan and Basilan Representative Mujib Hataman denounced the AFP chief's statements. But Gapay explains, it is just a possibility.
We're not saying that our madrasas here are radicalized, so nobody has to be offended with that statement.
Now the AFP is monitoring closely the succession of leadership within the Maute group after the death of top terrorist leader Abu Dar. The AFP is also monitoring the presence of foreign terrorists and recruitment efforts on different social media platforms. But the question among the affected residents of the city remains, when will Marawi City reclaim its former glory? The Joint Task Force Marawi is confident that the rehabilitation will be completed within the Duterte administration. But the president himself said it is not happening anytime soon.
And we will continue to spend until such time that Marawi is rebuilt to its former glory. It might take it's not easy to do that, but it might take some time before we can really reach the ideal place that you'd call home.
But leaders of the Bangsamoro Transition Authority demand answers.
By saying that it would take more time, we would like to qualify as to how long would it take for us to wait.
In the meantime, the local government through Mayor Mahul Gandamra assures his constituents that construction of major infrastructures will be completed by December 2021. Jeffrey Hernaez, ABS-CBN News.